Hey everybody, hope you're doing well. It's time to listen to another Jellyfish track off of one of the greatest sounding albums recorded in the 1990s. This is the Spilt Milk album, and we're going to do the song The Glutton of Sympathy. And I love the vocal harmonies on this. I also love the use of a Leslie effect on the guitar during the guitar solo. Without further ado, here's The Glutton of Sympathy by Jellyfish.
In the breathless hush of 4 a.m. In the dark sits a sad cliche, cloaked in the navy blue of slowly fading stars. Tell me how this came to be. Sleeplessness, talk to me. She'd say over and over again. Fumbling through a cut glass vase, passing lipstick, cotton spoons, burning jealous pictures of marriages, of friends. You never asked to be the glutton of sympathy. She says over and over, this is the end. 'Cause I see it in your eyes, what you don't. White snow vacant page, all the lessons that she learns, she packs away.
Seriously great sounding record. I'm telling you right now, if you like what you've heard on my channel for Jellyfish, go back and listen to them. Go check out the entire Spilt Milk album. Go check the entire Belly Button album. They are so perfectly recorded. It's honestly really impressive. It's really impressive. And this band could have been so much bigger than they eventually turned out to be. They had a window. They had about a 5-year window right in the early to middle part of the 90s where they were gaining traction. MTV was playing some of their videos, and they had some interviews that I saw. They, in the videos, I mean, in the interviews, they kind of rejected that people lumped him into sounding sort of inspired by the Grateful Dead, and they rejected that commentary, at least at the time they did. And it's fine. It's just, I think if they had been a little bit more open to accepting the commentary of that, they would have gained a bigger following and in the long run done a lot better for themselves. I don't want to say that's compromising artistic integrity, because all I'm saying is if they had just accepted it a little bit more with open arms instead of giving it the old Heisman. I mean, because when you think about it in the long run, the Grateful Dead fan base is gigantic, and it's propelled to great success bands like Fish and Widespread Panic, just to name a couple. And these guys were actually from the Bay Area, so if they had accepted it just a little bit, they probably would have had a bit more success than they did. But with that said, in my opinion, they've got two of the greatest sounding, greatest engineered, greatest produced albums of an entire decade. I mean, I can't really think of any albums that sounded significantly better. I can think of some albums that sounded as good, but not with the same diversity of instrumentation and sonic character. Like, as much as I love, you know, some of the Alice in Chains albums or Soundgarden albums or Stone Temple Pilot albums, those were also very straightforward rock-sounding albums, you know. It's not a lot of keyboards, not a lot of sonic character in the background. You know, it's more straightforward guitar, bass, drums, vocal, rock sounds. So, it's truly one of the great sounding albums or great sounding pair of albums that I can think of from that time period. With that said, thanks for watching. Please feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below. We can talk about it further. Just know that I appreciate you and I wish you all well. Okay? Y'all take care.